Hi there. In this lesson, you'll first learn about TCP IP sending and TCP IP receiving. Then we'll conclude the lesson with a TCP IP example to reinforce your understanding. Before we start, let's look at the diagram on the right and try to recall that in our previous lesson. So we mentioned that we normally send data from the application layer to link layer, and then we receive data the other way around. And now let's start with application layer. So first of all, we have this original data. Hello, how are you? And then at this point of time, there's no header transformation. The original data remains the same. And next, let's go to the transport layer. The data that we get from application layer would be the same, which is hello, how are you? And then at this stage, a TCP header will be added to the existing data. And then the contents of the header will be source port, destination port, sequence number, and etc. You do not have to memorize all the content within the header. Just a rough idea will do. And then by adding the TCP header, the resulting data will be TCP header plus the original message. Take note that at this transport layer, the data is known as segment. Now let's go to the internet layer. So the data that we get from transport layer would be TCP header plus original data. And at this stage, we'll add the IP header. The content of the IP header would include things like source IP address, destination IP address, and etc. The resulting data will be known as packet. So packet would include IP header from internet layer, TCP header from transport layer, and original data from the application layer. The final layer will be link layer. So as usual, we get the data from internet layer. Then we will add internet header, which includes destination MAC address, source MAC address, and etc. Now, the data will be known as frame, which include internet header, IP header, TCP header, and the original data. So this is the example of how the data is being transformed, starting from the application layer all the way to the link layer. Also take note that at every layer, the data has different naming due to different header added. Now let's look at the other way around from link layer to application layer. So at link layer, it will contain frame, which includes internet header, IP header, TCP header, and original data. And at internet layer, we will strip the internet header. And next, at the transport layer, we will strip the IP header. Finally, at the application layer, we will get back our original data. So this is how it works at the receiving side, starting from the link layer all the way back to the application layer. Now, let's look at one basic example to reinforce your understanding. We'll talk from a very high level perspective and only focus on the essential details. So for example, we have Rob here, a new superhero. He wants to send an email to Haguin here. In the next few slides, we'll see how this is being implemented from application layer all the way to link layer. First of all, at application layer, Rob will compose an email in his email client such as Outlook. And then the email content will include things like hello Haguin, let's meet for coffee. The data will be formatted according to email protocols. So for example, SMTP for sending. And next, at transport layer, Rob's email client will initiate a TCP connection to the email server. Now, the email is divided into TCP segments. Each segment is given a header with sequence numbers and other control information. And then at internet layer, Rob's device will prepare to send the data over the internet. And now each TCP segment is encapsulated in an IP packet with a header containing Rob's IP address, which is the source, and the email server's IP address, which is the destination. And lastly, at the link layer, Rob's local network will transmit the data across a physical network. The IP packets are placed within internet frames with necessary MAC addresses. So these are the high level data transformation at the sending side. And now let's look at link layer at Haguin's end. So first of all, at Haguin's local network side, it will receive the internet frames. And then the internet headers and trailers are removed and IP packets will be extracted. And next, at internet layer, Haguin's device will process the IP packets. And now, the IP headers will be removed, revealing the TCP segments. Now, at transport layer, Haguin's email client will receive the TCP segment. Now, the TCP headers will be removed. Segments are reassembled in order to reconstruct the email message. And then, at application layer, Haguin will open his email client such as Gmail and reads the email. The email will be presented in the original human readable format. So for example, hello Haguin, let's meet for coffee. So this is how the end-to-end workflows works in terms of sending all the way to the receiving side. Let's look at a quick summary of the TCP IP example. So at the sending process, it involves encapsulation at each layer, adding headers to prepare Rob's email for transmission. Whereas at the receiving process, it involves decapsulation, removing these headers and processing the data to reconstruct the original email for Haguin to read. In a nutshell, you can just imagine that at sending side, we'll keep adding header to the original message at each layer. Whereas at the receiving side, we'll keep stripping the headers to retrieve the original email.